tuning in. This is 9:50 a.m. WHVW, the heart and soul of American music, and you are listening to happenings around the Hudson Valley. My name is James Burke, and I'm sitting here with Stan the Boss Moss, and we're going to be bringing you news, views, and interviews about arts and entertainment here in the mid-Hudson Valley region. It's our pleasure to be talking to you right now. It's a cool, but not too cool morning. It's about 71 degrees right now, looking at about a 60% chance of rain. Overcast skies, might rain a little bit later on today, but right now it's nice outside. It was drizzling a little bit though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was just not quite hitting the ground. It was drying up as fast as it could fall. Good morning, everybody. This is Stan, the Boss Moss, and I hope everybody had a great week. But we're here this morning. I hope you're tuning in. And to get informed, you have to be informed. So
to be informed, you have to be involved. You got to be informed, and that's what we're here to do. We're here to help keep you up to date on the exciting stuff happening in the Mid-Hudson Valley region.
And there's a lot of stuff going on. That's for sure.
First, though, we have to acknowledge the larger country, the larger state, everything else that's going on in the world these days. Obviously, tomorrow is the 15th anniversary year since. It's the 14th anniversary. It's been 15 years since the World Trade Center attacks. So we'd like to start our show with about, say, 30 seconds of silence in memoriam of all the victims of that day.
Yes. Our prayers go out to the family and friends.
Crazy. I mean, I still remember that morning.
Yes, indeed. I lost two friends that I had worked with in the past, painting, and one of them actually worked his way into the towers as a window washer, and he was getting prepared, and that was in Tower 2, and never made it out of the building. So my prayers go out to the family of Mr. Timothy Cartwright, and it's been a long time since I've seen the family. Last time I seen them, they were painting with me up here in Poughkeepsie, and he became a window washer down there to support his family, and he was a very good tradesman. He was a master painter, and was offered a job down in the city, and he did some painting down there, but he only worked the second tower. He only worked there for about 7 or 8 months. So my prayers go out to the family, the Cartwright family.
Yes, absolutely.
He was a really good man, and really talented, extremely talented. And I had the pleasure of working with him in Poughkeepsie here with the revitalization of Dutchess County when they was actually changing the apartments here in the Main Street District to apartments, from businesses to apartment dwellings. And a very sad loss, but
he and everybody else all deserve better.
Yes.
And that whole week was so surreal for me. I remember right where I was. I'm sure everybody remembers right where they were when they heard the news. You know.
Yeah, I was actually in Arizona, where my daughter was born, and when I seen it, I just couldn't believe it. You know, it was horrific, truly horrific morning, and to know that that kicked us off into three separate conflicts overseas in the Middle East, you know, like one after another, Iraq, you know, the whole nine yards. Of course, we had our conflicts in Libya, now Syria, and it's just like, you know, all over the Middle East were involved in everything just because of that one trigger point. You know, one thing led to another. So. But but we have to come up with a solution, more peaceful, bring our boys home. They have families, they've been fighting for freedom, and not only that, we have to take care of them to the Veterans Administration, which is a big issue now in politics, but it has to be done.
Yeah, we have to take care of our veterans for sure. Post-traumatic stress disorder is so tricky, you know.
Right.
It's so hard to treat.
We're losing 20 veterans a day to suicide, so, you know, the average person, 99% of the population did not serve in the military, but could walk off the street right into a mental health clinic and get help. And the Veterans Administration should be more serviceable than that, you know. So, I mean, it is its own entity in itself, the VA. So, but I got some more reading material on that later on in the show, but where you can seek help.
Yeah. Got to take care of the veterans. Also, something that I've been really amazed at how much resistance this has received is the 9/11 First Responders Bill.
Yes.
Says there was a paper published last week I was reading about how everybody, all the firemen, all the paramedics who were there at the scene, you know, 15 years later, they're all dealing with some kind of severe illness, whether it be mental or physical, you know, with breathing in all the chemicals and stuff,
right.
Cancer or post-traumatic stress disorder.
Yeah, right.
Everybody who was there needs our help, and you know, funding for their treatments keeps getting vetoed by Congress. I don't get it.
That's one of the things that Congress has not dealt with. There's laws that need to be passed, and here we are looking at the 15th anniversary of this, and nothing has been done. It's just like the clock is still ticking, and it's looking worse and worse every day.
They passed a thing a few years ago, but it's since expired, and they didn't renew it.
Right.
You know, these people are still dealing with this.
Which is truly sad.
That
was a national emergency, and people who have money didn't involve themselves, by which I mean like Donald Trump, you know. I hate to throw it out there, but it's the truth, you know. I'll sit there and watch the news. You know, I do watch the news just like everybody else. And the man said he was, you know, he could see people jumping from the tower. You know, he lived 4 miles away, you know. And it's just, I call it the comedy channel of news. But this guy was born with a silver spoon in his mouth, but he can't get the spoon out of his mouth because it's his foot, you know. So I just don't know. And then he had the lecture in front of the forum in front of the VA, and some of the things he said just threw me. It really did.
You know, it's a good memory, though. I remember a couple months after when they had the fundraiser for the first responders, and it was at Madison Square Garden. This would have been October or November, don't remember exactly when. But they had this fundraiser for the first responders, and we've talked about him a couple times this year, because he passed away, unfortunately.
Right.
But I remember David Bowie opening the show with Heroes.
Right.
Yeah.
And they truly are.
Love that song, and it was a great performance watching him do that.
Yeah, it's a hard memory, 9/11, for me. It took me to another level of appreciation, you know, what people are capable of doing. It really pulled on every heartstring of everybody in the country. But it goes to the resolve of our nation and what we're capable of doing and what we're willing to do, you know. So it's sad what hasn't been done, but we do have that resolve within us, you know, to handle just about any disaster. But things need to be responded to quicker, whether it be a flood, hurricane, you know, or a man-made disaster. We should have something in place. I mean, we have FEMA, we have the Red Cross, but people rely on those way too much without support, you know. And it's a lot like Hurricane Katrina. With Hurricane Katrina, they just jammed everybody into the stadium in Texas and all over. But there's got to be something, some sort of plan, you know. you just can't sit there and wait on a hurricane to hit shore and just hope everybody can swim, you know. But, and even on a presidential level, you know, it shouldn't take 2 weeks, you know, for a response from the president to do something, you know. But we do appreciate what gets done, the resolve of people and the resilience of people to be able to function with what little they have after a major loss. Just like the floods down south here recently, you've seen people working on their own homes, putting sheetrock back in their homes and everything before they even had, you know, their insurance money come out, you know. And most of them received, you know, $10,000 emergency relief funds from FEMA. And FEMA was there before the hurricane hit, so it's getting better, but there's a lot more they can do, you know. So with that being said, we're getting better.
Of course, one more time, just want to extend our hearts to everybody who lost someone on September 11th, 2001.
Yes.
It's been 15 years. We know that the wounds haven't healed yet, but I think we're all in this together.
Yes, indeed. And if you get a chance, go out and buy a copy of The Red Bandana, which is about a young man in a volunteer fire department. And since he was a child, he carried a red bandana, and he actually lost his life on trying to take people out of the lobby, and he ended up losing his life. He worked for a volunteer fire department, and so if you get a chance, it's probably the most descriptive book put out. It's been out for years now, but if you get a chance, pick up a copy of The Red Bandana. It's a true story about the individual who had the red bandana, and what he did as a volunteer and lost his life doing so. But with that being said, I want to move on here because I don't want to make a depressing morning out of it. But our best wishes to all the ones that lost somebody, and our prayers go out to families and friends. And we'll move on now. So good morning, everybody. This is Stan the Boss Moss welcoming you to WHVW 950 AM, and right now it's 14 minutes after the hour of 6. So what's going on with you, big guy?
All right. Now, if you'd like to give us a call, it's 845-471-8180. We'd love to hear from you. If you have arts or entertainment events you want us to know about, you'd like to share with the community, please give us a call and do so. We have a list of our own stuff we'd like to read here, stuff that's going on in the area this weekend and beyond that we'd like to bring your attention to stuff that we're interested in, and I'll start the read right now.
Sounds like a plan.
Right. We're going to start up in Red Hook, up in northern Dutchess County. Community organizer, musician, educator, Maggie Rothwell. A friend of mine, fan of her music, she's a good songwriter, great singer. When she goes out and performs, she does some of her own original songs, but she also plays covers and medleys, and her medleys are really creative, the songs she does. So she'll be playing favorite songs from today and yesterday. Today she'll be performing starting at 10:30 as a part of Millbrook Community Day. That's going to be at 3281 Franklin Avenue in Millbrook. So if you're going to be out and about, 10:30 a.m., music by Maggie is going to be as part of the Millbrook Community Day.
Yeah.
And then next weekend, on the 18th, she'll be playing at the Taste Buds Cafe in Red Hook. That's a regular gig for her. So she does a lot to help musicians in the Red Hook, Rhinebeck, and Rhinecliff area to get work. She helps to organize the festivals over there, so I always want to make sure to mention her events because she deserves the attention and the recognition for what she does.
Amen.
I think I might have mentioned this last week. I hope I remember to, but you know, we always have guests coming in to our show to share their insights about their craft with us.
Yes.
It was a lot of fun this past summer. We had I think we had one or two people in here almost every week during July, August, and June. And that's going to continue. We have guests coming up later today. We're looking for the duo called SKEYE to join us. They're going to tell us about their new album, Stories of the American Frontier. Looking forward to hearing from them. But looking ahead, on the 8th of October, been trying to get this man in with us for a little while, Carl Allwire will be joining us.
He's a
fabulous guitar player himself. They call him the Eric Clapton of the Hudson Valley. I've heard him perform many, many times. He does. He hosts open mics around the area. The current one he does every Tuesday is at the Shelter in Rhinebeck. That's his bar.
Right.
It's sort of cool. You know, you park in the municipal lot, which is down near, just past Upstate Films, and they have the Smoky Rock Barbecue a little further down the street.
Right.
Well, you take that left, you park at the municipal lot, and it's sandwiched in between a few restaurants and boutiques. You walk down the stairs, so you're underground, hence the underground shelter. You know, they got the fireplace, it's the only lighting for it, so it's real dim, and they have this purple tint on the lampshades. Real cozy,
ambience.
Real romantic,
I love the
nice
ambience.
And I think they've been doing this for maybe 2 months, maybe 3 months.
Come on, you've got to check them out.
It's a relatively recent event. Carl hosts the open mic on Tuesday nights there, and a great group of people comes out to perform there. A lot of regulars. They're all great musicians. I love hearing them play. I don't get out as often as I used to, but it's always a fun time. Carl has two gigs of his own coming up tonight at 7 p.m. He'll be performing by himself at the Village Market and Eatery at 125 Main Street in Gardiner. So if you feel like making a little road trip over to Gardiner, seeing some great music, eating some great food, that's going to be going on tonight. Carl will be performing there at 7 p.m. Also, he'll be performing as part of the Red Hook Hardscrabble Day Festival. That's going to be with his group, The Real Men. They'll be playing at 2 p.m. Let me pull up the date for you. Just 1 second. That's going to be Saturday, September 17th. So next week, from 2 to 3 p.m. is a part of the Hardscrabble Day Festival in Red Hook. It's a street festival.
Right.
Just head out to Red Hook, park one of the municipal lots, and have a look around. Carl will be performing with his band, The Real Men. That's coming up, and to head down to the city of Poughkeepsie, and a little bit lower in the Hudson Valley. I know that Northern Dutchess County is a little bit of a drive from here.
Yes.
But for a little more local event going on here, I'm going to mention this every week until the deadline for all of the hip-hop musicians in Orange, Rockland, Westchester, and Dutchess County. That includes Poughkeepsie.
Yes,
a great hip-hop community here in Poughkeepsie. They are accepting nominations for Hudson Valley residents who have contributed to the growth of hip-hop. Your nominee must be a resident of Orange, Rockland, Westchester, or Dutchess County, at least 27 years of age or older, and must have a continued presence in the hip-hop community. Send them 200 words or less and tell them about your nominee. They'll be selecting three winners, all of whom will win a nice prize package to be announced at the winner's ceremony. Send your submissions to watchmemoveent@gmail.com. That's watchmemoveent. I assume, which is short for enterprises,
right.
Something like that. Watchmemoveent.
Entertainment.
Or maybe entertainment. Yeah, that's another good one. Probably entertainment. You're probably right. Watchmemoveent@gmail.com. The submission deadline is November 27th, so you have until the weekend of Thanksgiving. If you know a hip-hop musician who's been active for a long time and deserves some recognition for their work, you submit their name to this contest.
I've got two of them in mind right now, and I've been trying to get them on the show. And one has been on the show with us on several occasions, and that would be Derico Hyman, which is the founder and owner of Apple City Productions,
mm-hmm.
here in Poughkeepsie, which is one of the largest hip-hop promoters here in the city of Poughkeepsie. And that's the first one that comes to mind. But as far as bands and stuff like that, it would probably be Tri-State with Josh and Sima.
Yep.
They've been playing here for years, and I've been trying to get them on the show, but they're not available because they're in the studio right now. They have several albums. Sima is from Johannesburg, South Africa, where he's done several albums there. We went back to get married. Congratulations, Sima.
Mm-hmm.
And Josh Hankins, which is his partner. He lives right here in Poughkeepsie, and they have several albums out over the years, and they're very, very talented young men. That's Tri-State is the name of their group. So I'm going to try to get them on the air in the next week or two. I've already talked to them, but their schedule is really tight, and they're really doing some fantastic music. I wish they had the website where you could check it out, but as soon as I get them on the air, maybe we can get them to come in here and they can do a couple of songs for us. But yeah, that would be my first two that come to mind right offhand. But they do play, in fact, they was on the show several times with Mr. John Flowers and some other entertainers here.
So they'd be great nominees. If you have a nominee of your own, send them an email at watchmemovient@gmail.com. And November 27th, we're picking three winners.
Yep.
Get some recognition for their work.
I'll be on the phone with both of them and see if we can get Rico Hyman up here. And see if I can't get Josh and Sima up here and see what we can do over the next couple of weeks.
Absolutely.
So see what they think about it.
Absolutely. I'm just going to keep moving around. I'm kind of restless. I travel all over the Hudson Valley, so I have contacts all over the place, all over different cities, different venues that I enjoy going to, their event calendars.
Happening around the Hudson Valley, roving reporter.
Yeah. We're going to head over to Marlboro at the Falcon right now. They've got some good stuff coming up this weekend, next weekend.
Lovely place.
Yeah, big fan of the Falcon, beautiful venue, and they host great musicians too. Coming up tonight, the 10th, at 8 p.m., the opener's at 7.
Right.
Headliner hits at 8 p.m. You're going to hear the Chris Bergeron Band. I'm sorry, Bergson Band. Read that. I need new glasses. I've been working with this set of glasses for probably at least 3 years now, and I'm due for a new set. So the Chris Bergeson Band will be playing tonight at the Falcon at 8 p.m. Special guest, Corey Glover. If you don't know Corey Glover, you might know the band Living Color.
Yep.
He was the singer in Living Color. I'm a big fan of Living Color. And, you know, their first album came out. That was 1988. A long time ago. Corey still has his voice, though.
There you go.
His voice hasn't aged a day.
And you'll love the surroundings and the ambiance and be there or be square.
Yeah. So the Chris Bergeson Band with special guest Corey Glover, they'll be performing. And how about the opener? At 7 p.m., Shlomo Franklin.
Oh, right? Wow.
You know, young singer-songwriter. I've heard him play a couple of times. I caught him at the cafeteria in New Paltz and at the Rosendale Cafe in Rosendale. I think he lives in New York City now.
Right.
I think he grew up around here, though, or maybe in Rockland County, a little farther to the south.
Right.
But he comes up performing the Hudson Valley all the time, writes his own songs. Actually, our guest last weekend, Amy Madeline.
Right.
Remember, she and Shlomo just went on a little tour of the Northeast this summer.
Yeah, they she was just, talking about that.
They just wrapped up with that. So how about that, Shlomo Franklin? Well, he's a good songwriter, and I'm glad to see that he's getting more work.
Right.
Yeah.
On the road
again. This is a good gig for him. Yeah. So live at the Falcon tonight, 7 p.m., singer-songwriter Shlomo Franklin will be opening for the Chris Bergeson Band featuring Corey Glover. Be a good time. Also, you know, the Falcon, they have a new venue also, the Falcon Underground.
Right.
They have a little different selection of acts performing there. Tonight at 7 p.m. at the Falcon Underground, you can hear Big Joe Fitz and the Lo-Fis. Featuring Big Joe Fitz on vocals, harmonica, and guitar. Robert Bard is on bass. Mark Dezweba. Let me take a guess on that.
Right.
Maybe there's a silent letter in there. If you know that I'm mispronouncing that, please, I do that all the time. Give me a call. And don't be shy about correcting me, please. I'm just guessing here. Mark Dezweba on guitar and Eric Parker on drums.
Yeah, I do that quite often. As you know, I sit here and I'll say, wait a second, I'm trying to pronounce his name.
It's an interesting name. Dezweba. Maybe there's a silent letter in there. I'm not sure. If you know, please give us a call and tell us, because I don't want to butcher this poor guy's name.
Right. Not on the air.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to do it in person either. It could be truly embarrassing.
Looking ahead at the Falcon, on Sunday, the 11th, tomorrow, they're going to have brunch from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. featuring the Blues Farm. It's a group of Falcon regulars featuring Rob Paparosi, Pete Levin, John Tropia, and Lee Finkelstein. Also, tomorrow night at 7 p.m., you can hear Dave Stryker's 8-track. Featuring Dave Stryker on guitar, Joe Doubleday on vibraphone, Jared Gold on the organ, McClutty Hunter on drums. This should be fun. And vibraphone, there should be some interesting percussive music going on. Dave Stryker's 8-track will be performing at the Falcon tomorrow at 7 p.m. And looking ahead to the rest of this coming week, events that we might miss, because, you know, we're only on Saturdays.
Right.
On Wednesday, the 14th at 7 p.m. at the Falcon Underground, they're going to be having their jazz sessions night, hosted by internationally in-demand bassist Doug Weiss. Doug will be inviting world-renowned jazz artists to the Falcon's warm and intimate pub in progress, one floor down from our world-class live music stage. Check out their website for more information.
I'm going to have to do that. See, now jazz is what I love, because I love it, because I can sit there with my wine in the corner and enjoy myself.
The crazy thing about jazz, I find this isn't true for all kinds of music. Like, it's hard to sit down with a glass of wine when you're listening to hard rock.
Right.
Like, they don't mix. I can't imagine.
That's more like
maybe
beer.
Maybe yeah. Led Zeppelin's the exception.
Yeah.
But I can't imagine sitting down with a Pantera and a glass of red wine.
Motley Crue.
Yeah. But jazz seems to go equally well with beer and wine.
Yes.
I don't know what it is about jazz.
It's so social. It's really sociable and entertaining.
And in case you didn't hear, last month I think there was a paper published that concluded I at least had it backwards. I'd assumed this whole time that if you're listening to music, you want to loosen up and relax a little bit. Have a glass of beer or wine, some kind of alcohol, to help you relax and enjoy the music even more. Well, apparently, it's actually the other way around.
Right.
Listening to music makes you enjoy your drink more.
Exactly.
It's not your drink that makes you enjoy the music, it's the music that makes you enjoy
right.
your drink.
That's why I've never understood. When it comes to rock and roll, everybody wants to slam their beer outside the door or whatever, and then walk in and sit down and try to get into it. And I said, no, it's sociable, means you sit down and enjoy it at the same time.
Yeah. So the Falcon Underground on Wednesday, this coming Wednesday the 14th at 7 p.m., going to have some jazz music, but the lineup is to be announced. So please check the Falcons website for more information. Also on Thursday the 15th at 7 p.m., Connor Kennedy and Minstrel, hailing from the foothills of the Catskill Mountains. Connor Kennedy and Minstrel cut their proverbial teeth, bringing a sound from town to town up and down the Hudson River Valley they call home. I think I've heard them perform at Keegan Ales in Kingston
right.
once or twice. Local group, check them out. That'll be Thursday the 15th. And on Friday, the 16th at 7 p.m., the New Swing Sextet, featuring Angel Justiniano on vocals and congas, Harry Justiniano on bass and vocals, Thomas Martin Lopez on bongos and timbales and percussion, also on vocals, so the whole family sings here. Hector Ortiz will be playing bongos and timbales, Joe Manozzi will be playing piano, George Rodriguez on vibes and vocals, and Jose Chio Medina will be playing, will be the lead singer.
Right.
So, how about that? Lots of percussion, and everybody's going to be joining in on singing.
Right.
So, what a versatile and eclectic sound that's going to be.
Right.
That'll be the New Swing Sextet will be performing at the Falcon at 7 p.m. on Friday.
Now that's a venue.
Yeah. So it'll be a fun week of music at the Falcon. That's in Marlboro. If you feel like making the trip, please do. It's a beautiful venue. You'll be hearing some great music there, and I know that they will not disappoint.
No, they never do. They don't. They constantly. I think they have more concerts than anybody around as far as a local pub. I mean, and now they got two.
Yeah.
They're constantly having entertainment.
They have the main concert hall. I think it's a converted church.
Yeah.
Big. Open space, but now I guess they put their free space in the basement to good use, because they have a little pub going on down there where they're going to have some little different music.
We're looking downstairs and checking things out, so.
Friends, right now it's a little after 6:30. You're listening to the WHVW950AM. This is Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. My name is James Burke, and I'm sitting here with Stan.
Stan the Man Moss.
Stan the Boss Moss. I got you there. Yeah. We're bringing you news, views, and interviews about arts and entertainment here in the Mid-Hudson Valley region. If you'd like to share your thoughts with us, if you have an event coming up you want people to know about, please give us a call. Our phone number is 845-471-8180. We'd love to hear from you. Looking forward to having the duo SKEYE in studio with us this morning to share some insights about their new album, Stories from the American Frontier. Stories of the American Frontier, excuse me. Looking forward to that. But right now, we're reading off a list of some events that will be coming up this weekend and this coming week here in the Mid-Hudson Valley region. Before I turn it over to Stan for a little bit, just make mention some of the stuff that's been going on at the Art Bar in Kingston. That's on Broadway in Kingston, New York. Just opened up. It's a great little art gallery with a bar, and they have some appetizers also. The food menu is in progress. They're going to be bringing in a chef to really develop it this fall. The drink selection is nice. And as for the art gallery, I tell you, you're definitely going to see some good stuff, because the owner of the art bar, Allison Constant, is a trained visual artist herself. She studied at SUNY New Paltz. She grew up in Kingston, so this is as homegrown an establishment as you're going to find. And they have, I tell you, just from the past exhibits I've seen there this summer, they have great stuff. This month's exhibit is called Natural Surroundings by Marty Carey and Jane Bloodgood Adams. The opening reception was last weekend, the 3rd. The exhibit will run until the 25th. And they also host events throughout the month. Coming up next weekend, on Saturday, the 17th, they're going to have Swingin' Blues Dancing from 7:30 to 10 p.m. Intimate social gathering of our dance friends and family. $12 at the door. Here's some great music and get out and do some dancing. I know that swing is popular. I know that salsa is popular. They also, at the Art Bar, they also host tango. Right. If that's more your thing, on the 4th Saturday of each month, this month that's September 24th, starting at 8 p.m. It's called Malonga Kamilfat, Night of Tango Dancing. Music by DJ Viva. The door is also $12. But what got us involved with the Art Bar is this ongoing concert series they have.
Yes.
Another Kingston native, Brad Humble, has been organizing and promoting this concert series since June, and they are expanding it. Like, it started out as the Emerging Artist Classical Music Series.
Right.
This fall, they're going to be beginning a jazz concert series, and the first installment of that is in 2 weeks. So first up, they have the Emerging Artist Classical Music Series on Thursday, September 22nd at 7:30 p.m., featuring pianist Andrea Schott. And then on Friday, the following day, at 8 p.m., Mike Ohada and pianist Nick Hetko will be playing some jazz for you. Mike is a singer. She's studied all over the world, literally. She grew up in Japan and came here to complete her education. And Nick is also an international talent. In fact, coincidentally, he is currently on tour in Japan.
Oh, but world tour.
I think he's from around here, though. I didn't get a chance to speak with Nick, but back on Thursday, this past Thursday, I recorded interviews with Andrea and Maiko, and we'll have those for you next weekend. So tune in next weekend to hear our interviews with Andrea and Maiko, sharing their stories and their insights into the world of classical piano and jazz singing. Don't miss it, because they had some good stories to tell. Well, that's it for me for right now. I'll have some amusing headlines from this past week at the top of the hour. But right now, I'm just going to turn things over to Stan for a moment. He has some stuff that's a little bit more local in the city of Poughkeepsie and also some stuff from beyond. I'm waiting to hear it. Stan, what you got for us?
Yes, you're listening to the happenings around the Hudson Valley Multimedia Services. That's WHVW950AM, YouTube, and Facebook. Now for some local news. First of all, I'd like to start off with a good friend of mine, the Honorable Mayor, Mr. Rob Rawson, and the announcement and appointment of a city administrator, and her name is Ms. Deborah McDonald. I'd like to welcome her to the City Council of the City of Poughkeepsie. You can hear the buzz and without the sting. I would like to welcome her to the City of Poughkeepsie to help everybody get the city back on track, and I think it's a great thing. It's a long time coming, and I just wanted to give them a shout out. There's nothing wrong with the right thing. So with that being said, we're going to move on and see what's in the local news and exactly what's happening around Poughkeepsie and local areas. Gotta pull this up here. September 15th, we have a zoning working and walking tour of downtown Poughkeepsie. And like I said, that's going to be on September 15th from, let's see, at 14 Catherine Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. And that's going to be building blocks for revitalization. So if you want to join into that, you're most certainly welcome to. That's going to be at 14 Catherine Street. It's a walking tour of downtown. And it's really coming along great. Downtown is starting to come back to life. So if you want to check it out, get involved, I really recommend that. And so if you're interested, you can give them a call or just send them an email. Okay, so that's going to take place. And it was posted by Nathaniel Amita of Nubian Directions 2, which just so happened to him and his staff and students just finished doing Hume Park, painting the park over there, which I also posted on YouTube, the wonderful work that they did over there, which was fantastic. So just a shout out to them on that. And also today, which is September 10th, there's a fundraiser to benefit the Howland Public Library. So if you get a chance to get to the Howland Public Library, you might want to check that out. It is a fundraiser. So that's all the information I have on it, other than the fact that it's today. But that was posted on my Facebook, so that's all the information I really have on it. And if you're
I almost forgot to mention up to this point, our presence online. You can get in touch with us via the internet, of course. We have our Facebook group, Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. You can join the group. It's a public group. You can post your events, news, and announcements right there. And we always read some of the postings on our show. We also have our YouTube channel, Happenings Around the Hudson Valley, where we post our old shows and also some of the some recordings of events going on around the city of Poughkeepsie as well. Of course, you had the Father's Day Parade and the March Against Violence and a little thing about the restoration of the parks here. You can find us online. It's all the same name, Happenings Around the Hudson Valley, our channel on YouTube, and our group on Facebook.
Yep. And if you're interested in what's happening at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, on September 17th, we have the Dutchess County Yard Sale. And on September 23rd, Styx will be playing at the Civic Center. And on October 15th through the 16th, you have the Knife Show. And on November 5th and 6th, you have the Arts and Crafts Fair.
All right, so this is a wide variety of things going on here. It's not just music. There's also other, I would consider craftsmanship an art form of sorts.
Yes.
You know, building things. Even really all the artistry that goes into making some knives as well.
Yes, indeed.
You know, it's not so one-dimensional. There's many different ways that you can express yourself here.
Yep.
So the Arts and Crafts Fair and also the Knife Show.
Yes, indeed. Right. They have beautiful collections out there. Some of them you can purchase. Some of them are just showcase items, mm-hmm. like the Revolutionary Swords. Some of them are even older.
Right.
Some of them are from Roman-style swords. these, you know, there's just an endless collection of them that you can view, some of them that you can purchase.
There's more than just, you know, cutting your steak. There's also a lot of history there.
Yes, there is. Yeah. If you're interested in knives, bayonets, military weapons, you know, they have everything. They set up a lot of booths. You can go from booth to booth and check out, you know, some historical artifacts or some things are on sale. You know, so it really covers the entire spectrum. When you say knife show, they bring it out. You know, so some of them are museum quality pieces. Some of them are for sale. Some of them are not because of the value of them. Mm-hmm. But I'd like to move on to the Bardavon 1869 Theater.
Absolutely.
And I'm going to try to get this name right. Momanches is on September 22nd, okay? And for those who like classical music. And also for the children, there's a children's show coming up. And that's going to be September 24th. And that's Peppa Pig, which is a cartoon.
Oh yeah, I saw the advertisement for that.
Yeah, it's really popular with the kids.
I don't know anything about it.
It's actually pig characters,
yeah.
You know. So it's I think it's on Nickelodeon or the Cartoon Channel.
The commercial, it looked a lot like live action Sesame Street.
Right.
Except instead of Big Bird, they're pigs.
Yeah, but it is truly funny. The younger kids really love this show. Mm-hmm. You know, so, but they'll be starting there on September 24th. And then on October 23rd, you have the Cuba All-Stars will be playing at the Bardavon. And then on November 20th, you have Big Head Todd. So,
Big Head Todd, that's the early 90s jam band.
Yes, indeed. Yes. So, they have a wide variety of music coming out, entertainment.
Do you know if they sell season tickets at the Bardavon?
Yes, they do. I used to hold season tickets there.
And so you can have a night out, or probably not a night out, more like a morning or a mid-afternoon with your child. And then the following night for the, what was it, the Cuba showcase?
Yeah.
Yep. Night out for yourself.
Yeah, so you can get season tickets. Just check them at the box office there on Market Street. And they'll give you a price of the seasonal opera tickets, also their shows. For the children, stuff like whatever you're interested in, you can get entire season passes for all the shows.
Yeah.
But they're at different range prices.
Right.
So it depends on which ones you're interested in.
And speaking of the Emerging Artist Series up in Kingston, we've been covering this all summer, talking to the performers and Brad Humble and Allie Constant herself. They're also selling season tickets now. I should mention this, I forgot to. I just found out on Thursday. Tickets for individual performances are going to be $15. Or you can buy season tickets for $50 each. And that'll be good for all the performances they got coming up this fall.
Yes, indeed.
So remember to mention that.
And I've got one here that I truly do not miss every year. This is an event with very, very, very great consequences if it's not really taken care of. And not only that, this got so many hits on YouTube that I started this particular channel Happenings Around the Hudson on YouTube. This was the largest event that I've actually done. This one and also the global warming event. These two events was pretty much back to back. But I would suggest everybody who can get involved with it. It's the suicide prevention programs putting on Out of the Darkness walks, and it's going to take place on the walk across the Hudson Bridge. On the 25th of this month, that's 9:25, and the walk location is walk over the Hudson Bridge, on the Poughkeepsie side. The check-in registration time is going to be at 9:30 a.m., and the walk begins at 11 a.m., and the walk ends at 1:30 p.m. For more information, contact Melissa Ruff. You can give her a phone call at 845-243-4619. And
so
I really recommend
important.
That, and I would like to see everybody out there because I will be out there recording that event once again for the YouTube and Facebook channels, and we'll probably have a discussion on that later on, maybe next week.
Yeah, mental health is so tricky because unlike more physical ailments, like cancer is cancer.
Yes.
You have cancer, but mental illness, I feel like, is more subject to cultural definition.
Yes. Last time I was there, Sue Serena was there, Terry Gibson was there. You know, there was a lot of people who, you know, that you wouldn't normally think of, but that's unfortunately the case.
Right.
That people have went through it with family members and stuff like mm-hmm. that, you know, it affected in a big way.
For a long time,
there'll be a lot of speakers there.
Yeah. For instance, for a long time, it was impossible to get treatment for PTSD because the cultural attitude at the time was, I'll just suck it up.
Right.
Just get over it. You big baby. But now, that's not how we feel.
Yeah, it's easier said than done.
Yeah.
Unless you experience yourself, you just don't know.
Yeah.
You know.
Mental health is so tricky because of that. So that sounds like a great thing there.
Now for some...
It starts at 9:30.
Yes.
Yeah.
9:30 to 1:30.
What was the date again?
That was on the 29th. So we'll be discussing that right up to our end date, which is going to be on the 24th. And we'll have a discussion about that. Hopefully I can get somebody in here we can talk to directly about that.
Yeah.
So.
Real important. Hopefully make it out there, everybody. Right now it's a little after a quarter to the hour. You're listening to WHVW950AM. It's about 6:47. We'll be talking to you till 8 o'clock. That's when we turn it over to Joel Tyner. But right now you're listening to Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. My name is James Burke. I'm sitting here with Stan Moss, and we are bringing you news, views, and interviews about arts, entertainment, and culture here in the Hudson Valley. If you'd like to share your thoughts with us, our phone number is 845-471-8180. At the bottom of the next hour, we're looking forward to having the duo SKEYE in studio with us to share some insights about their new album, Stories of the American Frontier. But right now, we're reading off a list of some of the great events that will be coming up more locally here in the city of Poughkeepsie.
Yeah. And news you can use.
Turn it over to Stan.
Okay. On the September 17th, which is next Saturday, and I will definitely be there recording this event. It's the Hispanic Heritage Festival, and that's going to be going on in Early and Patrice Park, Manson Square Park, at 165 Manson Street here in Poughkeepsie. And it'll be going on from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. I'll be there to record that also for YouTube. It's brought to you by the Poughkeepsie Healthy Black and Latino Coalition. The activities include health screening, fun activities for kids, music featuring DJ Sanchez, live cultural dance performances, free confidential HIV testing, free food, free giveaways, free flu shots, and free mobile clinic. And it is a free event. So hopefully you'll come out. I'll be there recording the event, and I hope to see you there. Once again, that's Saturday, September 17th, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., and that's going to be in the Earlene Trees Park at 165 Manson Street, Poughkeepsie, New York, and the Hispanic Heritage Festival. Okay, on with the show. Success starts with school breakfast, so if you're interested in making sure that your child does get breakfast in the morning, you would want to contact Catholic Charities Community Services of Dutchess County and get in touch with Aileen Dahlia, and her number is 845-452-1400, extension 4243, and that's for school breakfast, free school breakfast for your child at school. So, and also, if you're interested in knowing which bus your child is taking to the middle school or high school, I have a number for you. The Dutchess County Public Transit schedule, you can give them a call at 845-473-8424, or you can dial their 800 number for further information. It's 800-924-8702. Okay, and that's in case you're interested in what bus your child will be taking to the middle school or to the high school. And also we have one here from HRH Care, Community Health. If you want to make a difference in your community, want to join a great group of caring individuals, want to help our community be healthier, become a health promoter. They have free training. You can be a patient advocate, get experience in healthcare settings, provide health education, connect individuals to services, or get volunteer experience. Great for your resume. If you're interested in finding out more information, you can contact Megan Gomez at HRH Care. That's at 29 North Hamilton Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. And that's all. That's also the Family Partnership Center. So just go on in there, and you would want to talk to, once again, Megan Gomez with HRH Care. So,
the Family Partnership does great work.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. And I do miss them, and I will be getting back to them once again. But until my surgeries and medical issues are taken care of, I still got two to go. So just did my follow-up on my first one Thursday. And they're scheduling me again. I got another one for the 20th.
How are you feeling?
Well, it's taking most of the pain out of my back, but I've got to go in and get like six more shots in my back, in my upper back. But and then they're going to do the surgeries after that. I want to make sure that I don't move when I'm sedated because they're working on my spine. But anyway, we was discussing the VA earlier. So for those veterans, supported services for veterans and families, and is the program of Hudson River Housing Incorporated. If you're interested in references or information of SSVF offices, it's located at 38 North Clinton Street, Poughkeepsie, New York, 12601. You can just give them a call at 845-232-5754. And you can also hit them up on your computer at www.hudsonriverhousing.org. Okay, and so if you do need services and you want to find out information, that's the place to do it, at SSVF.
Don't be shy. If you need the help, please. One thing that you told me, Stan, when we first started working together about living in the city of Poughkeepsie, is how great the social services here are.
Yes.
If you need to get back on your feet, there are few places in the world that are better to be than Poughkeepsie.
Right. And it's the same with across the river in Highland. They have one located there, too. It is phenomenal. It is phenomenal. It's like a one-stop place for care, dental. You know, they feed the hungry. You know, they have a lunchbox. And they have a place for the homeless to be during the day while they look for employment or whatever, or assistance in whatever their needs may be. So it is a phenomenal place. You can volunteer there. There's after-school programs there. And I just love the place, and I'm glad I was able to help what little I could when they first moved in there. But, we got another one here from People's Incorporated, where hope greets you at the door and recovery is the expectation. Okay, projects to empower and organize the psychiatrically labeled. Okay, and that's People's Incorporated. That's located at 126 Innis Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York, and our 112 North Front Street in Kingston, New York. And let's see, where's your phone number here? Okay, here we go. Okay, 112 North Front Street, Kingston, New York, is 845-452-2728. And they also have peer advocacy, Reach One Recovery Center, housing programs, hospital diversion housing, jobs and benefit council, engagement center, and representative payees, and a program called Warm Lions. And that's put on by People's Incorporated. So check them out. And they have a lot of great services, and they're located throughout the Hudson Valley. So I definitely would give them a call if you need services. Like I said, it's located at 126 Ennis Avenue in Poughkeepsie, New York, is their main office. And moving on, we have Nobody Deserves to Be Abused. And that's Gray Smith House Incorporated, 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. And if you need more information, just call 845-471-3033. They can help. 90 to 95% of domestic violence survivors are women. 28% of all annual violence against women is perpetrated by inmates, which is a sad thing to hear.
Sorry to correct you, that's intimates.
Mispronunciation.
Yeah, I was doing it too. I mean, I still have no idea how to pronounce that word.
It catches you. You're trying to keep a certain flow with it, and you just boom.
It's
finishing it
off. Yeah, with the silent letters.
Okay. Protecting the innocents from the effects of family violence. This is also the Grace Smith House Incorporated at 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York, 845-452-7155. And it is also 90% of children from violent homes witness their fathers beating their mothers. 63% of all boys aged 11 to 20 years old who commit murder kill the man who was abusing their mother. Children in homes where violence occurs are physically abused or neglected at a rate of 1,500% higher than that of national average. So if you need help with either one of these situations, please contact the Grace Smith House Incorporated, 1 Brookside Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York, 12601. The phone number is 845-452-7155.
If you think you might need help, there might be a sign that you do. I know sometimes with these things, it's hard to just take that first step. For a lot of reasons, but the help is there. Please go get it.
Yes, no doubt. You won't get answers unless you ask questions. And the other one, the Mediation Center for Dutchess County. What is bullying? Bullying is when somebody deliberately and on purpose says or does mean hurtful things to another person who has a hard time defending himself or herself, and they have resources for bullying, the Mediation of Dutchess County Anti-Bullying Initiative. You can contact them at 845-471-7213. So if you have any problems and need to identify them as bullying, please contact them. I'll give you the number once again because it's such a serious problem. It is 845-471-7213. And that's the Mediation Center of Dutchess County. Okay. The rest of the news I got coming up locally here in Dutchess County, Rhinebeck, and the surrounding areas of Dutchess County is places and numbers that you can use to contact to see what's on their venue. Their venues change throughout the year, and it's becoming that time of year. Things like the fair is going to be coming to town. If you want to find out their venue, I can give you the name, number. I'll be covering Statsburg, Rhinebeck, and surrounding areas. So I'm going to get started real quick and get through this because time's allotted and we got about 2 minutes to seven. You're listening to WHVW 950 AM and happenings around the Hudson Multimedia Services. Okay, we're going to start off with the Old Rhinebeck Aerodrome, 9 Norton Road, Red Hook, New York. Their number is 845-752-3200. And you have Statsburg State Historical Site, 75 Mills Mansion Road, and that's in Statsburg, New York. Their number is 845-889-8851. And like I said earlier, the fair is going to be coming into town soon. If you need the dates and prices, just contact the Dutchess County Fairgrounds, which is at 6550 Springbrook Avenue in Rhinebeck, New York. Their number is 845-876-4000. During the month of August, okay? So if you want to know the date and times that's coming up, all you have to do is just give them a call. And also locally, we have the Franklin D. Roosevelt Presidential Library and Museum at 4079 Omni Post Road, Hyde Park, New York. Their number is 845-486-7770. And the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, which we announced earlier, 14 Civic Center Plaza, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their number is 854-554-5800. And right down the street, which I'm trying to get in touch with them because they have one of my favorite bands from the 80s, Judas Priest, coming up soon, and I want to get more information on that. The Chance Theater at 6 Grinnell Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. And if you want to check out their venue coming up, just give them a call at 845-471-1966. Very good year.
I was at the Chance like 10 years ago. I just thought of this, because I'm sure there'll be at least a little bit of this for Judas Priest. I was at the Chance about 10 years ago. They had a tribute to Sublime that night, right? And my date insisted we sit in the front row. right up against the stage. No, they get started, and about 30 seconds after they get started, I got people pushing on me. I turn around, and I see there's this one guy in a black shirt with this really long hair, just kind of running in a circle, slamming into people.
Yeah, I've seen some great entertainers. I've seen Pat Benatar there. I've seen Hart perform there. And now they got Judas Priest. Alice Cooper's performed there. So many people, so many great entertainers have performed there. So checking out their venue is really worthwhile. Because if you see them at the Civic Center, chances are they're going to play the Chance Theater.
Just as an aside, isn't it amusing how perception changes? Like when Alice Cooper first came out, he was doing all that. The stuff with the guillotine and
the preacher's son.
And stuff, you know? People were horrified.
Yeah.
No, but now today it's like, oh, it's Alice Cooper. You know, it's cute what he does. You know?
Yep. The same with Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah. It's
I'll roll a bat.
It's almost cute. You know, it's fun. It's Halloween. It's
right.
Fun, you know, but back in 1970, it's like, oh my God, save the children.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Back to locations and entertainment. We have the Vanderbilt Mansion National Historic Site, which is 119 Vanderbilt Park Road in Hyde Park. And their number is 845-229-7770. It's a beautiful historic mansion out there for tours. So give them a call and see when they're open for tours. And then also we have one that we mentioned before, Bartabon 1869 Opera House at 35 Market Street, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their number is 845-473-2072, who was discussing seasonal tickets, so you can find out that's the number to the box office. And the Stormville Airport Antique Show and Flea Market, which is at 428 New York, 216 Stormville, New York, and that's at 845-221-6561. And also the Mid-Hudson Children's Museum, if you want to get out with the kids, 75 North Border Street, down by the river, in Poughkeepsie, New York. That's 845-471-0589. And then we have the Wilderstein Historical Site at 330 Morton Road in Rhinebeck, New York. That's 845-876-4818. And now, if you want to get out and have a few laughs, and this place is always open.
Who doesn't want to have a few laughs?
Yeah, I mean, just to get out and have some good comedy entertainment with some national comedians, high-class comedians. That would be the Bananas Comedy Club, located at 2170 South Road, Poughkeepsie, New York. That's at 845-462-3333. It's a very nice club. It really is. But you get some good stand-up comedy there. And also a place that we recorded once before, about a year ago. And that's the Coon and Hackett Art Center at 9 Vassar Street, Poughkeepsie, New York, 845-486-4571. And also with the suicide prevention and the Walk Over the Hudson's venue and fundraisers, you can give them a call at Walkway Over the Hudson Valley, and that's at 64 Parker Avenue, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their number is 845-834-2867. And also right here locally in Poughkeepsie, you have the Locust Grove Museum, and that's located at 2683 South Road, Poughkeepsie, New York. Their number is 845-454-4500. Always great events going on there. Okay, and if you want to load up the truck before the snow flies and just put the kids in the back of the truck and just drive on out, you can check out the Overlook Drive-In Theater while the season still demands. And that's located at 126 Derrigamo Road, Poughkeepsie, New York. Southern accent just jumped out there for a second. That's at 845-452-3445.
After I was living in Louisiana for a few years, I had a noticeable little bit of the Al Gore in my voice. It just came out sometimes. I couldn't stop it.
That's like people think the Clintons are originally from New York, not Arkansas. But anyway, if you're into arts and entertainment, there is a place real local, and I really like stopping by there on occasion. That's the Barrett Arts Center, and that's at 55 Knoxon Street, Poughkeepsie, New York, and their number is 845-471-2550, and that's just a couple of blocks away from my house, and I have a lot of Barrett paintings in my house, and I love them.
They're beautiful.
Now, if you'd like to just get out on a sunny day, while we still have sunny days, and you're the type of person that like to hit your balls with a club, you can always join them at the McCain Golf Course at 155 Wilbur Boulevard in Poughkeepsie, New York. And that's at 845-454-1968. So that's it with the local news here in the city of Poughkeepsie and the surrounding area of the Hudson Valley. And this is Stan DeBoss Moss, and I'm going to turn it over and catch my breath.
Yeah, thank you very much, Stan. Lots of good stuff to keep you busy all around the city of Poughkeepsie and the surrounding areas, as you can tell. Right now, it's a little after 7 o'clock, about 7:07. We'll be with you till 8 o'clock. This is Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. 950 AM WHVW. My name is James Burke. We're looking forward to having the duo SKEYE in studio with us at the bottom of the hour. They'll be telling us about their new album, Stories of the American Frontier. Looking forward to that. Right now, I just want to take a little break from the news and lighten things up a little bit with more news, different kind of news, my favorite headlines from the week. Did this last week. I think I'm going to keep trying to do this because it amuses me how creative editors get to sell newspapers and to get page clicks on the internet. Here's some of my favorite headlines from the week. First up, the school year is off to a fabulous start.
I hope so.
Right. emergency response team triggered at U.S. school after 40 students eat one of the world's hottest peppers.
Ooh. That's a hot tamale.
Like the lunch ladies are running out of milk. The emergency team busts into the place expecting to find, you know, blood and gore. That's just kids about doubled over on the table holding their stomachs.
Oh, Lord.
Because they ate the ghost pepper and they didn't know what it was. You know, we're off to a great start.
Yeah, right? Who hired the chef?
Yeah, really. This I find... Like, I want to be there when this happens. Because I know it will, all right? There's a police department in Bath, Michigan. Bath, Michigan, yes. You know, we're all worried about the Zika virus and what it can do to children. Right, well, if you're worried, if you are worried that your batch of homemade crystal meth may have the Zika virus in it, the Bath Police Department will check it for you. Just bring it to them, they'll have their team look at it, and in the meantime, you can have a seat.
Yeah, right? No.
I want to be there.
In a room with a view.
Yeah. I want to be there.
Here in this room. Don't worry about bar slamming. Wait right here.
Worried about Zika in your meth? Bath, Michigan Police Department will check it for you. Love that.
I wonder how many people are going to answer to that call. I wouldn't want to hurt anybody.
So, I'm not going to go into too much detail about this. This is rather macabre, all right? In case you don't know, way back in the 1990s, there was a rap group called the Insane Clown Posse.
Yeah.
Yes, these two guys dressed up like clowns and did this, you know, horrible rap music about killing people. Their diehard fans are called Juggalos.
Yeah.
I'm not sure where the name comes from, but they call themselves Juggalos. They dress up like clowns, go to concerts, and chug orange soda. I don't get it. But, so I'm only going to read the headline, not going to go into any detail. As far as I know, everybody is okay. But also in Michigan, in Wisconsin.
Right.
In Wisconsin. Man charged in Juggalo blood drinking ritual.
Well, that's a little bit different than Shasta.
people are pretty strange.
Yes. So I think I heard a report a couple of weeks ago about clowns running through the woods and stuff like that.
That's down in South Carolina.
Yeah. People are reporting clowns running through the woods. Yep. I was just wondering if that was the same group.
It very well could be. People are strange, man. So I'm just going to leave it at that. I thought that stood out as being especially strange.
maybe they got a hold of the meth, the Zika meth. So get your meth checked today.
this may all be interrelated, man. You never know. Maybe. So I thought that was especially noteworthy, so I'd read it, but I'm not going to go into too much detail because that's gruesome.
Yes.
I'm a big fan of George Carlin. Loved George Carlin, you know.
Yes.
So he has a new album coming out.
Right.
New comedy performance. It's set for release this coming Friday, September 16th. Tomorrow is 15 years since September 11th when the World Trade Center attacks.
Right.
Well, on September 10th, 2001, George recorded a stand-up special for HBO
right. That
he had to put on the shelf.
Yeah, archived. Right?
Yes, because he'd been wanting to use this title for years.
Yeah.
And he finally felt like he had the right material to go with the title. Right? It's called I Kinda Like It When a Lot of People Die.
What are the odds? I don't know how that's gonna go over, but it's a comedy album.
What are the odds?
Yeah.
It's like he'd been wanting to use this title since the early 1990s.
Right.
Finally had what he thought was the right routine of just enough whimsy and macabre humor
right.
to go with the title. He records it on September 10th, and then the following morning, the World Trade Center attacks happen.
Wow.
It gets even spookier. One of the jokes is an Osama bin Laden joke. What are the odds? What are the odds?
That's a collector there already. Yeah.
So, anyway, a couple of weeks later, he records a slightly more lighthearted performance, removes some of the jokes, and that became Complaints and Grievances, which I think was released in November.
Right.
So, after sitting in his vault for 15 years, his estate has decided that the time is finally right to release the show.
Yeah.
So, big fan of George Carlin, you're a big fan of George Carlin. On September 16th, I kind of like it. When a Lot of People Die is finally getting released.
Right.
But I thought that was amazing.
Yeah.
All the coincidences.
Right. As long as people understand that it wasn't written about it. It was written before it.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, that's the main thing. And it'll probably do really good as long as people understand that. But it's not written as an insult or anything.
Yeah. Just what an amazing coincidence.
But the strange thing is if the president would have listened to it, he'd probably known Osama bin Laden's name. Because they didn't know anything about it.
I thought, what a headline that was.
Right?
George Carlin. I kind of like it when a lot of people die. Final news headline that I got, three science headlines that I thought were really amusing. The titles of a few papers that were published this week. But the final news headline I wanted to close with, because this is sad, but it's also pretty amusing. 70-year-old man robs a bank and then just sits down in the lobby and waits for the police to get him. Because, and I quote, I'd rather be in jail than at home with my wife.
She probably wants half.
It's like the honeymooners got horribly wrong.
Yeah, right? Yeah. I could picture her in court. Can I have half?
Yeah.
I'll take 35.
So, anyway, three amusing science stories this week. Papers published. Scientists have found evidence of a sixth taste associated with carb-heavy food, which may explain why we like starch so much.
Now that's interesting.
What do we do? I'll put this delicately. Again, the phrasing of this headline caught my eye. I think it's kind of amusing. I'll put this delicately. Having relations frequently and enjoying it. That's the important part. You have to enjoy it. Puts older men, but not women, at risk for hypertension and heart attacks.
Yes, yes, indeed.
For women, it's actually beneficial.
Right.
But for older men, it's actually dangerous.
Yes.
But you have to enjoy it. If you don't enjoy it, you're in the clear.
Yeah. So, you can go with a smile on your face.
If you find yourself enjoying it, think bad thoughts and you'll be okay. I just thought it was an amazing headline. So
it is. I just picture a lot of people, I hate my wife, I hate my wife, I hate my wife. Older people at that, you know. But the
70-year-old man who robbed the bank was still having heart palpitations, so he thought he needed to up the ante a bit.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, he did it for himself. All right, wrapping up here, just...
That is crazy.
What I thought were amusing headlines from the week. Cuttlefish found to count better than toddlers.
What?
Yeah, cuttlefish. They put shrimp, different quantities of shrimp in a cage, lowered it into the tank with the cuttlefish.
Right.
And found that the cuttlefish would always go to the larger amount of shrimp first. They changed the quantities, and they found that the response time varied depending on how big the difference was. Like if you had 5 shrimp in one thing and 4 shrimp in another, the cuttlefish would go right away. Right. But if it was 5 and 2, it took a moment for the fish to make its decision, which they thought meant that the shrimp must be counting.
Right.
The shrimp. Right? So they tested this, I think, all the way up to groups of 5, and the shrimp always picked the right larger amount.
Yeah.
But human toddlers couldn't do that once the amount got higher than 3. Up to 3 shrimp.
Right.
A toddler could pick the bigger amount, but once you went above 3, the toddler couldn't count anymore.
I'm just wondering if it depended on how hungry the cuttlefish was. So I'm going to go get the big meal instead of the little meal.
That may be one thing they didn't control for. So, yeah.
Instead of the 2, I'll take the 5. That's a mega meal.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Super size one.
Yeah, right?
Yeah. Super size
meal. I don't want 2 French fries. I want the whole meal.
Yeah.
You know. But, you know, just questions. Just questions. I don't know. I'm not a scientist.
I think I'll keep doing that every week.
A little bit of humor in the day.
A little bit of humor. Some of it dark humor this week, but, kind of the way things turned out.
We're all Americans. Just some of them are a little bit further out from the coastline than others.
Yeah. A little bit of humor. Some headlines I thought were amusing this week.
Yeah.
We'll see what we have next week. Hopefully, little bit more lighthearted stuff.
Right.
Had
it's a good way to start your day.
Had to be a little dark this week, because that's just the kind of week it was.
Yes, indeed.
Well, it's about 7:20, friends. You're listening to Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. This is WHVW950AM. My name is James Burke, and I'm sitting here with Stan, the Boss Moss. I think we'll do a quick recap of the morning read, all the stuff that's going on this week and beyond in the Hudson Valley. Hopefully at the bottom of the hour, we're looking to have the duo SKEYE from Kingston. They'll be joining us. They have a new album out called Stories of the American Frontier.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear about that.
We got about 10 minutes to go until I start to... I ask our guests to arrive at 7:30, because I know we're on early.
Yes.
And the thing about musicians especially is we are out so late at night, because that's just the business hours for live music. We're out late.
So
it's tough to get people up this early after they've been out till like 12 or 1 the previous night to get them in here at 6. So I ask our guests to arrive at 7:30 at the earliest. I think that's a little more reasonable, a little more manageable, especially if they have to travel to get here.
Yeah.
Not everybody I know is in Poughkeepsie. There are people from New Paltz, Rosendale, Kingston, Red Hook.
So true.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Well, I didn't have a seat.
How's it going?
All right. So our guests have arrived, but we're going to do a quick recap of the events coming up in the Hudson Valley this week, and we'll be speaking with SKEYE in just a few minutes. In the meantime, I'll mention again music by Maggie Rothwell today at 10:30 a.m. as part of Millbrook Community Day. That's at 3281 Franklin Avenue in Millbrook. Maggie will also be performing on the 18th at Taste Buds Cafe. Maggie helps to organize festivals and concerts up in Northern Dutchess County. I think it's only fair that she gets some advertisement for her events as well.
Yes, indeed.
Also, very excited to announce that Carl Allwire is going to be joining us in studio on the 8th of October. He's a fabulous guitar player, and I'm looking forward to having some insights from him. But he's got two shows of his own coming up. First, he'll be playing by himself tonight at 7 p.m. at the Village Market and Eatery at 125 Main Street in Gardiner. So if you feel like taking a little road trip over to Gardiner, you can hear him perform and you won't regret it. Also performing, I believe, on the 17th, I will double check. He will be performing with his group, The Real Men, at 2 p.m. as a part of the Red Hook Hard Scrabble Day Festival. Yes, that is the 17th, so 1 week from today at 2 p.m., part of the Red Hook Hard Scrabble Day Festival, street festival. Just park at one of the municipal lots and have a walk around and enjoy some of the festivities. The Art Bar in Kingston, on that would be the third Saturday. That's when they have their swing dancing night. Just pull up the exact date for you. So I can give you the time, is what it is. Everybody knows when the third Saturday month is. It's the third Saturday. But yeah, starting at 7:30, they're going to have swing and blues dance at the Art Bar. Admission is $12, so head out there and enjoy some swing music and some of the beautiful artwork that they always have on display there. Once again, the proprietor of the Art Bar is a trained visual artist herself. She studied painting and the visual arts at SUNY New Paltz. You're always going to see some good stuff there. But they branch out. They do more than just visual art. They also host music and dancing. And this month, on the 22nd and the 23rd, they'll have the this month's installment of the Emerging Artist Classical Music Series featuring Andrea Schott on the 22nd. And on the 23rd, the new jazz series will be starting up with vocalist Mike Ohada and accompanied by Nick Hetko on piano. Looking forward to that. On Thursday, I recorded interviews with Andrea and Mike, and we'll have that for you next week, sharing their insights about music, about playing piano, about their travels. And I forgot to mention BSP in Kingston earlier. They have some good stuff coming up. On the 10th, that's tonight at 11:30 p.m. in the front room, they have a night of dancing with DJ Shaman Vibes. And on the 16th, that's this coming Friday, Uptown Swing, Bottoms Up Dixieland Jazz Band. He's playing at 7 p.m. at the Back Room Theater. How eclectic, you know?
Yeah,
right. EDM tonight, next week, Dixieland Jazz. There's something for everybody.
Yeah. Like I said, I love the jazz music. I mean, I sit down and relax with good glass of wine, you know.
And let me pull up the Falcon calendar, because a friend of ours, Shlomo Franklin, will be opening tonight. Let me pull that up. Turn it over to you, Stan, for just a minute while I do this.
All right.
What's going on in the world this week?
Well, I would once again, I'd like to just mention real quick a good friend of mine, the Honorable Mayor Rob Rawlinson. Appointed the city of Poughkeepsie an administrator, a city administrator. Let me get this back up again. And that would be Mrs. Deborah McDonald to the city administrative office. And I would like to welcome her to the city of Poughkeepsie Common Council to keep this moving forward, the city of Poughkeepsie and the reconstruction of downtown. We haven't had an administrator for quite some time. But I just want to give the mayor, he is a good friend of mine, and just give him a shout out. And the city of Poughkeepsie has been going on it's been on the road to coming back for a long time, you know. And since the election, he's been doing a wonderful job, such as restoring the downtown Poughkeepsie area. Also Nathaniel Armida from Nubian Directions 2 right here, which is located right on Main Street. And their zoning workshop and walking tour, which was right up and down Main Street here, 14 Catherine Street, which just took place. I want to give them props and also the work that they did in Hume Park, which is the first park you run across coming across the bridge, the FDR. They really restored it, and it really looks nice. But as far as entertainment goes, they do have I hate not having web in here, so I'm doing this off of my pictures. On September 10th, which is today, they have the fundraiser to benefit the Howland Public Library. And so if you can get by there, if you want to make a donation to the Howland Public Library, you can. Their fundraiser is today. And I don't have the time on it because it wasn't posted on Happenings Around the Hudson. And as you know, Happenings Around the Hudson is a multimedia event company. And that's with WHVW950AM and YouTube, which we're recording the show for, and Facebook, all under the same name. Now, we'll go over the events once again at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, the Dutchess County Yard Sale, September 17th. And Styx will be playing at the Civic Center on September 23rd. The Knife Show is going to be October 15th through 16th. And the Arts and Crafts Fair will be on November 5th and 6th. And moving on from there, we will... The Bartabon, 1869 Theater. You've got a little something for everybody there. So, Meninches is on September 22nd. For the children, you have Peppa Pig on September 24th. The Cuba All-Stars on October 23rd. And Big Head Todd will be playing November 20th.
And they do offer season tickets?
Yep.
Offer
and if you're interested in season tickets, I do have a phone number on my morning read paper. And like I said, the biggest event that we had on YouTube is coming up on the 29th. And that's the suicide prevention walk across the Mid-Hudson Bridge. That's coming up on the 29th. And that's going to be from 11 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. If you want more information, you just have to give them a call. I had the information on the other one, but you can get in touch with Miss Melissa Ruff, and the contact number is 845-234-4619. And that's about it for happenings around the Hudson and events in Poughkeepsie and the local area.
Yeah, it's a great cause, too. Please
yes,
be shy about getting involved.
Between that and
so
global
tricky.
Warming, I had over a million hits before I changed the YouTube and the multimedia service over to happenings around the Hudson. So that event I will definitely be covering.
And wrapping up with the Falcon, tonight at 8 p.m. you can hear the Chris Bergson Band with special guest Corey Glover. Opening for them at 7 is Shlomo Franklin. He was just out on a tour with Amy Madeline, who was our guest last week. Just wrapped up a tour of the Northeast, and he'll be opening for the Chris Bergson Band tonight at 7. Also tonight at 7 at the Falcon Underground, which is the pub in progress, they call it.
Yeah.
A new venue they're developing. We can hear Big Joe Fitz and the Lo-Fis. Tomorrow morning from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., they have the Blues Farm Brunch. And also tomorrow at 7 p.m., you can hear Dave Stryker's 8-track. Looking ahead to the week at the Falcon, on Wednesday the 14th at 7 p.m., they have jazz sessions at the Falcon Underground for the lineup. Check out their website. It is currently to be announced. And on Thursday the 15th at 7 p.m., you can hear Connor Kennedy and Minstrel. And wrapping things up here, on the 16th, this coming Friday at 7 p.m. on the main stage, you can hear the New Swing Sextet. So lots of great music of all different kinds all over the Hudson Valley, and we are proud to bring it to you. You're listening to 950 AM WHVW. This is Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. You can find us on Facebook and YouTube under that name. Happenings Around the Hudson Valley is our public group. You can join it and share your events and your thoughts right there. You can also find us on YouTube, our channel. We keep an archive of our past shows.
Yes,
also
indeed.
Any events around the city of Poughkeepsie that we're able to get out and film. The March Against Violence is there. The Father's Day Parade is there. And also the documentaries about the restoration of the parks. So,
yes.
Several different ways to get in touch with us. and to experience the Hudson Valley. And we're just trying to bring all of that to you every week.
Yes, and we will be looking for volunteers coming from Vassar College, Marist College, and Dutchess Community College to join us for the winter. For those students who would like to be involved, get credits from the college that are interested in broadcasting and community information, they can receive credits here coming on the air with us and also reporting on what's happening around the college. Same as last year, and congratulations once again to Ms. Kelsey Cox, who graduated last year and now is doing a news show in Chicago.
Yes.
We do miss her dearly and hope she gets us a call.
Yes, congratulations to her. Loved working with her last year. Looking forward to working with someone else in college. I had a thought. What was I about to say? I forgot it. In and out. in and out of my head. Oh, that's right. I was going to say.
Early morning.
Next week, we're here every week from 6 to 8 a.m. Next week, we're going to have interviews with Mike O'Hara and Andrea Schott about their performances at the Art Bar in Kingston. But this week, we have a guest in studio with us, and we're very glad to have them here, the duo SKEYE. Thank you for joining us. We are glad to have you.
Hey, how's it going?
So, good morning.
Good morning, guys.
I don't think I can. No. It's okay. I don't need to.
Yeah.
Right.
As you said,
we do have sound. Not all of our headphones are on.
Okay.
Thanks for joining us.
Would you care to introduce yourself or something?
Sure. I'm Lindsay Morano.
I'm John Blasio.
Okay. Yeah, it's nice to meet both of you.
Nice
and
to you
too. What do you guys do? I'm just going to just jump right into this real quick. What do you guys do? You're entertainers, right?
Yeah, yes. We're musicians.
Love it already. I'm a music fanatic, so
you got
my interest. So how long have you been musicians? You guys play together, right?
Yep.
Okay. What's the name of your band?
SKEYE.
SKEYE. Okay.
It's spelled SKEYE.
Yeah.
Okay. Easier.
Just information for viewing audience and listening audience. Mm-hmm. But do you guys have a venue or are you on tour or?
No, we are mainly an online band.
Right.
We're really interested in recording techniques and connecting with an online audience.
Right.
We started out with YouTube videos, just kind of to
get
our bearings.
We're on one now.
Yeah, good, great. it was just kind of to see where we could go with that, and then we started to experiment with recording techniques and focusing mainly on how different rooms sound.
Right.
And started with covers and started writing original music, and so at this point we've released 4 original albums and grown our YouTube channel.
Would you mind telling our listening audience what account you have?
If you go to youtube.com/vectormusic, and that's VEKTOR music.
Okay, I'll be looking that up today. So.
Yeah, I think we're up to like 80 something videos. We've been building it for quite a while.
Oh, cool.
I like to do this in 3 sections. We have just introduce yourselves, your past projects, and your current projects.
Mm-hmm.
So let's start at the beginning. How did you two get together, and what started the band?
We met when I was in art school.
New Pulse.
Yeah. And I was studying visual arts, and then we decided to do music. John was in school for music.
I didn't go to New Pulse.
No. I went to New Pulse. We went to 5 Towns.
Yeah. So it's quite a distance.
Paintings or film?
Paintings.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what musical interests did you share that made you think that it would be a good idea to collaborate?
We liked pretty much all the same bands.
Yeah.
Well, that helps.
Yeah
right.
We saw it as practice. We used to go to the school late night, and we'll bring like film and equipment and audio equipment. We'll just record in the stairwells there. You know, for the ambiance and
right.
The sound.
Every room has its own.
You can screw up and it still sounded good.
Right. I'm just saying, no, you didn't.
It's funny too. The people we would meet, like, you know, like if there were maintenance men there late at night, they'd come into the stair and be like, "You guys sound awesome. What are you doing here?" And we're like, "If you want me to let you in anywhere else, let us know." And it's really nice to meet.
We started there. It's good practice, really good practice.
And then we started recording in the studio.
Yeah, we built our own studio, and that's where we do most of our stuff now.
that and Dreamland Recording Studio in West Hurley.
Right.
Very novel approach, focusing on the different acoustic properties of different rooms.
Yeah,
I mean, really, it doesn't matter what kind of equipment you have, as long as the room sounds great.
Yeah,
right.
It becomes part of the performance, you know. It's like, what song we were doing would inform which kind of room we would look for, and then we would kind of just, you know, we would bring a guitar and just go from room to room saying, oh, it doesn't sound right in here, let's go to the next one. You know?
We're not feeling it.
Yeah. And there's such a variety, because there's lecture halls, there's stairwells, there's just smaller classrooms. So there's such a huge variety of sounds.
Are there any trends you've noticed about different rooms and different instruments or different sounds?
Lecture halls sound great with pianos. I don't
sure.
know. It's cool because, like, a lecture hall is such a dynamic place, because when you're in the quieter part of a song, you barely hear the room at all, and it's very intimate.
Mm-hmm.
But then when you get much more dramatic and dynamic, you actually hear the whole room come out, and it's more of, like, almost a play or, you know, some kind of theater performance.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the most, I think, flexible.
Yeah, we were pretty strategic about it. I mean, like, a lot of our ballady kind of style we did in the stairwells of New Paul's College, and a lot of, like, the, you know, the more upbeat or fast-paced songs we did in, like, the lecture room. So, you know, it went from long reverb time to shorter, like,
mm-hmm.
slapback delay, you know.
Right.
So that's the way we approached it, and then, you know, the studio is completely different. I mean, you could put all that stuff on.
Right.
But it did inform, like, the way we record
yeah.
in the studio, too, because even now, like, we're just always still after that natural sound. We don't like to record a dry take and then just dump a whole bunch of effects on it. We're more about getting it into the track in a natural way, or at least recording it and then reamping it in a cool room.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we've done
right.
that too, where you take an amplifier somewhere that has great acoustics and record that. So it's just, it's influenced the way we record in the studio.
So do you prefer to record indoors instead of outdoor live concerts? And
Yeah, anywhere where we can use the space to
We've recorded it outside before.
Yeah.
And we try to, like, use that as,
yeah.
like,
lawnmowers in the
yeah.
It's a little distorted.
Yeah, we
and
had, like,
birds and
distant
stuff.
Microphones.
Right.
Yeah.
With clean delay.
I know the pain. I had, I was tasked with recording a festival back in the spring, set up on the lawn in front of this museum, and we had traffic.
Here comes a fire truck.
Had to cut that out, or to just make it part of the sound.
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, we did one video. We did a cover of a Natasha Bedingfield song,
mm-hmm.
where we did it in Lindsay's mom's backyard, and we literally used anything we can find. We used a 5 gallon bucket. That's like yeah. I used it as like a snare drum.
Yeah.
And there was a guy with his tractor mower in the background. And I'm surprised you cannot hear any of that in the recording.
Yeah.
But he was mowing the whole time we were recording.
Like, there's no way this
yeah.
is going to work.
Somehow, I guess, all the tracks were just engulfed with tractor mower, where it just canceled out.
You got the
noise
cancellation
funny.
Right on every track.
I'm just surprised
you don't notice it. It's a very novel approach to it. I like that. Tell us about, I know you have a new recording out right now, Songs of, Stories of the American Frontier.
Right.
Right. But what about your previous recordings? How has your sound changed as you've gone through all these albums?
Well, we always try to keep an experimental approach in everything that we do. We really don't try to do the same thing twice. Our first album was called Euphoria, and that was by far the darkest album.
It was called Euphoria.
Blueforia. Yeah.
Okay.
Get off on the right foot. It's a little dark.
That was a concept album. I guess that wasn't the smartest way to go about it, but we tried to make every song, like, flow into each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then we made it so the first song looped into the last song, so when you play it on repeat, it just sounds
right.
like one album.
That's neat.
Playing over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
Or it just flowed together even.
And that was recorded over the course of like 4 years, I think. That took a long time.
Because we started it when we first met. So we're at the time we were still doing YouTube videos. So
mm-hmm.
it was
right.
like we were doing that for YouTube, and then we were, just, you know, recording stuff slowly in the studio. But yeah, 4 years later, it came out.
Yeah.
Do you guys record things off of your experiences as far as incentives to write songs and stuff?
Oh yeah, definitely, definitely. Yeah, we try to include all of that.
Inspirations.
Yeah, and for me, I'm hungry all the time for that.
Right.
I'm always looking for new inspiration. I find myself always.
Yeah, because you don't see that much anymore. You used to, you know, people write songs, you know, on the back of a bus and on a tour, you know, and they
yeah.
come on the concert and they'd sing it, you know, and try it out on an audience before they put it on an album and stuff like that. But you don't see people writing their own music, you know, which has a lot of feeling to them, you know. But as far as personal experience, so that's the reason I asked that question.
Yeah, definitely.
Usually it's a remake or somebody's doing somebody else's music, you know, and they put their own mark on it, and it really, it's really not their experience, you know, so it's not from the heart.
It's not genuine.
Right.
I think it's inevitable for us. Anything we write is deeply personal.
Right.
Yeah.
At least we're shaping it that way.
Right.
If it doesn't come from the heart right at the beginning.
Right.
It's usually a... I mean, if it doesn't, it usually starts as a scrap idea.
Right.
And then it kind of shapes into something that we're like, oh, this is our baby.
Right. I like that. I like that because you just don't see it anymore. You really don't.
Yeah, from the beginning, we've been after the kind of just really genuine approach. The same thing with, you know, when you're watching our YouTube video, the room you see is the room you hear in the recording. And that
right.
helps people feel like they're there with us.
Yeah,
exactly.
To us perform, and so.
Yeah, whether the room doesn't look nice or not, it's just
yeah.
the fact that
it's here.
Yeah,
it's
when you're hearing. It's not like some fake reverb I just threw
yeah.
on.
Yeah, that, oh man.
It's like, oh, I'm in my bathroom.
Like, you see a video of someone and they're performing outside, and then it's just drenched in fake reverb.
Yeah,
like,
which to me,
this.
It's like, it takes me out of the
yeah.
vibe.
Right?
It takes me right out of it.
So, before you, it was a concept album.
Mm-hmm.
And where did you go from there?
Well, then we went to Seeing the Stars, which I guess was maybe more like singer-songwriter, would you say? How would you describe that?
Yeah, that was, we tried to keep it pretty minimal.
Yeah,
That was another thing. We didn't want too much layering going on to make it sound,
yeah.
you know, I guess, fake. Yeah, I don't know.
Well, there's
sorry,
so much going
word.
On in Bluephoria that we were like, okay, let's take a breath
yeah,
and slim it down a bit, simplify it, and yeah. That one's kind of hard to describe, but then we also released YouTube Sessions, which was a culmination of all of our original video songs from YouTube, so it was another original one. And then our new one, Stories of the American Frontier, I think is completely different. We describe it as a space western.
Right. Well, let's
yeah.
jump into discussion of this one, then.
Yeah, it's really about storytelling, which I don't think any of our other previous works really... involved. We're kind of writing, we wrote the album as like a movie that didn't exist. So, like a soundtrack for a movie that didn't exist.
The spaghetti western style.
Yeah, we're watching a lot of those.
Yeah.
The old Clint Eastwood.
Yeah, I guess what really inspired it was my brother came back from China after he married his wife, and he bought me an ocarina.
Right.
I think it was in China.
Yeah.
And
no,
she's
no,
like, oh,
Chinese
that
place.
Sounds exactly like that song. From, was it the, what's that Italian western called? The Big Bad and Ugly? Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, The Good, the Bad,
yeah.
Yeah,
The Good, Bad, the Ugly, yeah. And, you know, it has an ocarina, and I'm like, oh, that reminds me of that song. So it kind of just, like, paved the way to a space western
right.
kind of style.
That's cool. Now, are you guys playing at any particular place coming up?
No.
we're
planning,
but.
Online
yeah.
concerts. That's, like,
okay.
be our next thing, I think. It's gotten good responses in the past because we don't have like a really solid local following because we keep kind of a low profile in the area, actually.
Yeah.
So you will now.
Yeah.
You will now. That's the reason I asked, is there any place that we can go to see?
Yeah, we were doing the live thing like really solidly about a year ago. But yeah, now we've just been focusing on promoting online.
Well, we've been focused on releasing the album.
Yeah.
Now we just got a Patreon page.
Mm-hmm.
What's it?
It's patreon.com/SKEYE.
S-K-E-Y-E.
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 Yes.
Whoops. Sorry.
That's fine. Yeah, we take that page like as an opportunity to just share extra stuff with our fans because yeah, we found a lot of people, they like to see behind the scenes or like it's all massive progress, it's not done yet, so share that.
Yeah. Well, we try to promote that also, the local artists and talent and stuff like that, if they can get out and see them or if they're just trying to promote an album, you know, stuff like that, because it takes like 500 sales, you know, of a CD or an album in order to get playtime on the radio, stuff like that. So we end up promoting things through like open mic night, you know, where people are trying to sell albums online, you know, where they get played on the radio airtime and stuff like that. The interviews and stuff, we try to, that's the reason I asked you, you know, is there any venue that you're playing? But I'm sure that people are going to be interested in your website, so.
Yeah, we got plenty of material all along.
Yeah,
the collection. Yeah, people actually, and I know I do, I put on YouTube and just listen to music. I put on like 8 or 9 albums and just listen to them. Mm-hmm. And I always listen to the music, especially when I have guests, so I'll be on there. So,
lots of material there.
Yeah, we have quite a few followers on ours, but it'll be interesting, so I'm looking forward to it. With that being said, the new album that you have, I take it it's not on the market, it's just on YouTube, right?
Oh, no, it's on Bandcamp. We haven't gotten to, I don't know if we're going to do the iTunes thing this time, but yeah, sky.bandcamp.com, that's where you can get it.
I'll be checking that out.
What else? That's Space Western.
Yeah,
we tried. Yeah.
We have a friend who had these like really spacey instruments, the polyvolver.
Yeah, we have a bunch of different synthesizers, and we use like a lot of old tape echo.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just stuff to kind of like morph the sound, and it just sounded, everything sounded weird.
But
I mean, how would you describe
it?
Space Western?
Yeah, right.
So we did our own interpretation.
The story behind it is kind of like, you know, it's called Stories of the American Frontier. So it's kind of people living in the old American West. They're on the frontier. They're searching for new land. They're leaving their home. They're going on a journey. And while they're out there, strange things happen. And so each song is kind of each person's interpretation of what happens. Like, you know, I mean, there might be people who believe in ghosts or angels or demons and angels and aliens. And so it's kind of like, you know, what do you believe? Do you think that these people are actually seeing this, or it's just their interpretation? Are they crazy? And
right.
It's really just like, listen to the songs, and then you decide what's really going on.
Like a wagon train through Area 51.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Because throughout history, people have experienced such weird things, but depending on the time in which you live and your beliefs, it seems to determine how you're going to interpret your experiences.
Right.
Well, friends, Sky has their Facebook page, they have the Bandcamp page where you can find the new album. They also have their YouTube channel, so look later today on our Facebook group, Happenings Around the Hudson Valley.
Yes,
we'll have a link to this interview and a link to their YouTube channel, so you can check out some of their music. They have a new album out right now, Songs of the American Frontier.
Stories.
I keep saying so much. Why do we keep saying? I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Stories of the American Frontier. It's out now, and I'm looking forward to listening to it. Sounds very interesting. It sounds like how would you say if you had to put like genre labels on your sound? Ambient.
Dreamy.
Dreamy.
Soul. Blues.
I think I'm going to have to check out. I'm going to put this on my widescreen TV and check this out.
Very exciting collection, for sure. So thank you very much for joining us. Is there anything else you'd like our listeners to know about your future activities or anything you're doing right now?
We're just going to keep making music. We're going to come back to YouTube now that we've released the album, so you can expect to see more video songs from us, youtube.com/vectormusic.
Okay.
And it's Vector with a K.
Yes.
Yes, I got that right.
Yeah.
All right.
And this show will be downloaded later on today, and it will be on Happenings Around the Hudson Multimedia Services, which is WHVW950AM, and you can also find it on Facebook, so it's the radio show, YouTube, and Facebook. They all under the same names, Happening Around the Hudson Valley.
Okay.
So if you want to check out today's show, I'll have it downloaded later on today. So I really appreciate you guys being here.
Yeah, thanks
I
so
really
much.
Do.
I appreciate you guys having us.
It was a pleasure meeting you.
Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, too. Sir.
Thank you, everybody. You just heard from SKEYE. They have a new single out right now called You're Leaving Me. I Will Wait. And we'll have that posted to our Facebook group. You can find that on their YouTube channel. And I strongly recommend you check out their new music, Stories of the American Frontier. Thank you for joining us.
Wonderful people doing great things.
We got about 10 minutes left right now. It's 7:50, and you're listening to WHVW950AM. This is Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. You can find us on YouTube and Facebook. Our Facebook group is Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. It's all under that same name. On our Facebook group, you can join it. You can post your events. You can also read about other people's events, and you can share your thoughts with one another.
Content on the events and videos.
And we always read a selection of the events that are coming up this week. We'll also be uploading our show today, and all of our previous shows can all be found on YouTube, on our YouTube channel. We also record events around the city of Poughkeepsie, and we publish those videos on YouTube as well. So later on today, look for a link to today's show and a link to SKEYE's YouTube channel as well. They have some new music out. We've got about 10 minutes left. There's plenty of great stuff going on around the area today. I know that later on, Maggie Rothwell is going to be performing as part of the Millbrook Community Day. She starts at 10:30. Also later today at the Village Market and Eatery in Gardner, Carl Allweyer is going to be performing. Carl Allweyer will be our guest on October 8th. We're looking forward to
yes,
having
indeed.
Him.
Yes, indeed.
Next weekend on the 17th, we'll have our interviews with Andrea Schott and Mike O'Hara. Andrea will be performing at the Emerging Artist Classical Music Series at the Art Bar in Kingston on the 22nd. On the 23rd, the new jazz series at the Art Bar will feature Maiko. She's a singer. She'll be performing there along with her accompanist, Mr. Hetko. Pull up his last name. He's on tour. They're both international talents. Maiko is from, she is from Japan, and Nick, coincidentally, is performing in Japan right now. He's on tour.
Yes, and I'm going to try to get Rico Hyman, from, which is the founder and owner of Apple City Productions here in Poughkeepsie, to join us, hopefully next week, but I got to check his schedule because he is checking out some performers here locally and to sign up to his production company. And also Josh Henkin and Sima. Like I said, Sima's from South Africa, Johannesburg, and they have several albums out, and I'd like to get them on the show. So we got a long venue coming up. We're booking them weeks and weeks in advance. So we've got a lot of things coming up on our venue. But I would like to state that some of these performers that play on tour are hard to lock down. And they really are, because they're busy. They're either on the road or they're in the studios. But I'm going to snatch them up. That's the reason I want to bring the Rico Hyman in here and see some of the bands that are playing for him and not in the studio right now. Mm-hmm. See if we can get him on the air.
And remember, on the topic of DeRico and his work in the hip-hop community.
Yes.
Right now, for residents of the lower Hudson Valley in Orange, Rochester, Rockland.
Yes, Rockland County.
Orange, Rockland County, Westchester, and also the lower Dutchess Valley, Dutchess County,
yes.
Here in Poughkeepsie. There's an ongoing contest for musicians who have contributed to the hip-hop community.
Yes.
Must be at least 27 years of age and have an ongoing presence in the community. If you would like to nominate somebody you know, you can send them an email at watchmemoveent@gmail.com. Submissions will be accepted until November 27th. That's the weekend of Thanksgiving.
Yes, indeed. And like I said, there's two right off the top of my head. One of them would be DeRico's Apple City Productions, and the other one would be Tri-State with J-Dot Simo.
Mm-hmm.
They've been performing here for several years, for the past 12 years now, and they have worldwide sales throughout Japan and here.
Mm-hmm.
in the U.S. So they're coming out of Poughkeepsie, growing up in Poughkeepsie. I think it would be the, you know, par for the course. I mean, most of their music is based around, you know, some of the crime shootings and things like that that they have written for the families and stuff, and survivors. But those would be my first two, as far as nominees for that. So.
There are many in the hip-hop community of Poughkeepsie, just by itself.
It's hidden talent. It's got to be brought to the surface. There's so much talent in the Hudson Valley that it really needs to be amplified. It needs to be brought to the surface. There's just so much talent. It always has been that way since the 50s and 60s. Not just Woodstock, but there's just so much untapped talent that it really needs to be. And that's why we do what we do. You know, we put it out there as much as we can. And we do it for you guys out there, and we do it because we love it. You can't call it a job if you don't love what you do. So
if you do love what you do.
Yeah, and I get up early in the morning every Saturday to come down here. I've been doing it for over a year, so I'm considered blessed to help other people. So I've been volunteering for the past 23 years, so I'm fixing to be 24 in February. So. This is where you can find me, Stan DeVos Moss. Happenings around the Hudson Valley on YouTube, radio, and Facebook for commentary. And this is WHVW950AM. And you can actually get us a call, but we're fixing to go off the air in 4 minutes anyway. Mr. Joel Tyner is going to come in with his political news and views. So,
Councilman, right? Councilman is his title?
Legislator.
Legislator.
Rhinebeck Legislator.
Legislator from Rhinebeck. Hopefully we'll get a break from the rain a little bit. Because we are getting a break from the heat. It's only 69 degrees outside right now. Good day to get out and do some stuff and see some music, see some entertainment.
I worry about the humidity that comes afterwards. Because it's supposed to be like 90 degrees. If it rains for 5 minutes and then all of a sudden like, oh God.
Well, hopefully we'll be getting a break from the heat today. It says a high of 89, but right now it's 69 and it is raining. So hopefully the rain will clear up.
Yes, and just once again, we had a moment of silence earlier at the start of the show for the 9/11 victims and families, and I just want to say once more that our hearts and prayers go out to the families and victims of 9/11, and we hope that you're getting through your situations, and it's hard. I've lost a few friends in that, so it's a little rough, but time heals all. If you do need some help, we announced it earlier on the show where you can seek help. But like I said, our hearts and prayers go out to you, and you have a blessed week.
Yes, please. I think we're going to call it a day. Thank you for joining us this week on Happenings Around the Hudson Valley. We'll be back with you next weekend and every weekend at 6 a.m. Thank you for joining us, and stay tuned for Joel Tyner.
Yeah, you have a blessed day and a better tomorrow.